Hey, what's up everybody? My name is Trophinut and welcome back to Bioshock and our Let's Replay series, which I'm gonna use to try and tell you as much about the game as I can. We're still here in, well, outside the Kashmir restaurant. And we're gonna try and zap these little fellows in the water because they were stupid enough to be rummaging around in a pool of water. So, hi! That is nice. And I'm gonna have to wait because I get damaged as well in electrocuted water. So let's clean these guys out. Let's clear out the Big Daddy corpse as well, which was carrying a lot of money for some reason. And, well, here we go. So we need to head not to the medical pavilion, but to Neptune's Bounty. That's where we need to go. But there's another restroom here as well. Not really sure if there are enemies in here. Fancy looking toilets though. But nothing else of the sort. The wall is completely gone here, so no separation of the sexes here. So let's see. Well, we need to head over there, I suppose, but there's a lot more loot. Oh shit. So that's why you're careful when picking up loot, because now I'm drunk. Not for that long, though. Good morning, Rapture! Stay up to date. Neptune's Bounty! Oh, shit. I'm gonna hide in the toilet, because I kinda know what's coming right now. So there's a few going up there. So if these jump down, I can zap the water. So, well, everything is gone to shit. There we go. I'm gonna have to take a close look around. And stuff is exploding everywhere. Go down. There those go. I can't check out the corpses, but I'm afraid I'm gonna get stabbed in the back. I'm waiting for it picking up everything up. So, we can't go to Neptune's Bounty because Andrew Ryan shut us off and there's a turret behind the gate. So I'm gonna move towards the medical pavilion. So, something crashed in here as well. And, well, there's the way out. Oh, of course.
Oh, Christ. You're trapped. Gonna try to override the exit from here.
Well, I hope you can hurry. So this is another very nice scene, and a bit of the real introduction to Andrew Ryan.
One of the bitches sent to you, the KGB wolf, or the CIA jackal. Here's the news. Rapture isn't some sunken ship for you to plunder, and Andrew Ryan isn't a giddy socialite who could be slapped around by government muscle. And with that, farewell, or thus Mavania, the Jerry.
So Andrew Ryan thinks we're some kind of government agent or someone to take down his city. He's become extremely paranoid, and there's three splices banging on the windows, and they apparently seem to be successful in getting out. But I need to get out. Is it? You got it? Okay, great. I don't actually know if they can get through, because hi. It doesn't look like they can, but hey, here we go to the medical pavilion. So, in each of the areas we're gonna come across from now on, each area is gonna be themed around, well, a certain craft. And the first one, of course, is medicine. And we'll come across pretty much every facet of medicine. So yeah. Here we go, I suppose. It's also home of one of the most iconic bad guys in, well, I would say recent history, but Bioshock is a pretty old game. I think it's 2008, 2007. And there we hear the Circus of Value, and that poster hasn't loaded in. Trophy earned, completed, welcome.
Now find your way to emergency access.
We will. Emergency access route. So it's Dr. Steinman's cosmetic enhancement. So plastic surgery is a commodity in Rapture. Introducing the future of health and wellness. The Vita Chamber. Restore vigor and spirit with the touch of a button. And also life, if you remember. So, the medical pavilion. We can hear a lot of splicers already. But right now I don't think we can get attacked. Medical service cache. Let's see if we can find anything here. Release today. And there is Diane McClintock again. So Diane went to Dr. Steinman to repair any damage that occurred after the attack she suffered. The attack we heard, the explosions on New Year's Eve. And, well, somebody had an accident. Somebody had a bit too much fun with a wheelchair. Don't know where that came from. Because it looks like she was, I don't know, tossed from over there right into the railing, which broke the railing, but apparently kept her over here. And dropped the sign down a bit. And well, we're gonna check out our first Circus of Value. And a nice bit of trivia here is that the voice you hear narrating the Circus of Value is actually the game's creator, Mr. Kevin Levine. So that's also a very nice thing to know. So right now I don't think we need anything. Those electric bucks will come in handy in the future, but we don't really have enough funds to for that right now. So let's keep that for now. Let's see, we also have a security bolt which is disabled. We can search it, but it's empty, and then we can hack it. And hacking is really, really simple. You probably played this game when you were a little. We have a lot of tiles that are uncovered, and we need to guide the fluid from the starting point to the ending point. Simple as that. So, there we go. And that should finish it up. So, we can press triangle to speed this up. And we hacked it. So, hacked security bolts will fight by our side. And we get another trophy for hacking a security bolt. Yeah, Bioshock is really, really generous with its trophies. Because we got another one. Trophy earned, one successful hack. We can also hack the vending machine right now. And you can see those are a bit tougher to gather. So let's try to buy ourselves a bit of time here. And slowly make our way up. I think it's better to do it like this. The longer it takes for the fluid to get there, the more time we have to finish this little puzzle. And of course, these get exponentially harder and harder. So, but for now, these are easily manageable. And I'll probably skip most of them once we've gotten the hang of it. So there we go. And what hacking a vending machine does is it expands the inventory, because we now can buy armor-piercing pistol rounds and normal shotgun ammo. And everything is also a lot cheaper, so there's actually not really a reason why you wouldn't hack a vending machine. But still, we don't really need anything right now. I'm wondering if I have my pistol. Yeah, okay. Should reload that just in case. So that now that bolt is gonna follow us in a really, well, comical manner. I'm gonna see if I can. And she's being attacked by another splicer. So I'm gonna let them attack each other while we take advantage of the situation. So yeah, they're having fun. They are having fun. And there's. Wait, what? Okay. So that's the handy thing about bolts, they can take care of pretty much anything. As long as they're alive, of course. Adam and so Dr. Steinman.
All those years of study, and was I ever truly a surgeon before I met them? How we clinked away with our scalpels and toy morality. Yes, we could lop a boil here and shave down a beak there, but could we really change anything? No, but Adam gives us the means to do it. And Ryan frees us from the phony ethics that held us back. Change your look, change your sex, change your race. It's yours to change. Nobody else's.
So since Adam allows you to completely modify your genetic structure, it's also a very handy tool for plastic surgeons, of course. And he's really grateful towards Andrew Ryan for that. So let's see. Activate the emergency access control. And of course, access has been denied. And we're gonna get attacked here.
If you want to use the emergency access, you'll be needing Dr. Steinman's key.
And I went down because she's upstairs, I think. And she's got a bullet in the face.
Steinman ain't that kind, and frankly, I'm not even sure he's still human.
So, indicating that Steinman, well, he has been experimenting with Adam himself a lot. So let's see. And here we have the machine gun. Look at that. But now we can use the electrical override switch to open up the gate up there. And restart power. Here they come. Well, can they? Yeah, they can fire through that. So I'm gonna head back and go to a more advantageous position. I think, well, as you can see, the machine gun is pretty useless, I think. So, I actually prefer the pistol more. And they're having fun with my turret, I think. Oh! Okay, thank you, Bolt. Thank you, Bolt. Whew! Okay, so later on we can actually upgrade those bots. And it's not over yet! I'm gonna keep eating on her, she's distracted by the bolt. Wow, okay. So next up, we need to try and find Dr. Steinman to, well, relieve this lockdown. And Steinman is the only one with the key. I think we still heard footsteps, but I might be a bit paranoid about that. Eve running on empty, fill up with Eve. And then there's only the best for our discerning customers. So, well, another dead body. Which is doing a lot for the atmosphere here. Yeah, you're gonna be a star. So there's a lot of banter between the splicers themselves as well. And, here we have another ghost memory. And that somehow also caused the lights to flicker. So there's another corpse here, probably electrocuted herself when she tried to access this health station. Well, we can use the door.
You keep an eye peeled for Steinman, but that bastard set up shop in the surgery wing. You want to find him? Just follow the blood.
Above all, do no harm. Steinman. So that's the oath each doctor swears, do no harm. But that doesn't look like Steinman has followed that. And as you can see, he likes to manipulate pictures as well. And there's another diary of Steinman.
Adam presents new problems for the profession. As your tools improved, so do your standards. There was a time I was happy enough to take off a wart or two, or turn a real circus freak into something you can show in the daylight, but that was then. When we took what we got, but with Adam, the flesh becomes clay. What excuse do we have not to sculpt and sculpt and sculpt until the job is done?
Yeah, so, that's a bit like everybody getting power they don't deserve. So right now, we have a turret to take care of. Turrets are a bit special in Bioshock 1, because you can hack those. Let's start hacking those, and as you can see, those red tiles we can't cross, obviously. And when turrets are hacked, they actually do the same thing as the bots. So they fight for us instead of the enemy. Well, I think these turrets are actually used to kill pretty much everything that walks around here, so... maybe just... I don't know if there's another horizontal. There we go. There we go! So hack turrets are friendly and will attack your enemies. There we go. So now our bot also stops attacking that. So now that Splicer is walking into the wrong thing. So there's another turret over there. So shocking them stops them from shooting at you. Although you can't start hacking them because time freezes when you hack. You can't start hacking them without, but hey, what's the fun in that? And another friendly turret, and they keep, well, they stay here in the on the map until, well, something destroys them. So another first aid kit. So as I said, I don't like the machine pistol really. Oh shit, yeah. That was stupid of me, because I stood in front of the turret. That's not great, is it? This thing is already on fire, and I can't really repair it, so another diary from Andrew Ryan this time.
The parasite expects the docs to heal them for free, the bomber to feed them out of charity. How little they differ from the pervert who prowls the streets looking for a victim he can ravish for his grotesque amusement.
So another one of Andrew Ryan's rash opinions. Was there another one behind us? Because that was really fast. Let's pick up every ammo we can get, because ammo might be pretty scarce sometimes. Let's see another diary, because, well, Bioshock is all about the diaries.
I was a German prison.
Dr. Tannenbaum.
I was 16 years old when I realized I have love for science. German doctor, he make experiment. Sometime he makes scientific error. I tell him of this error, and this make him angry. But then he asks, how can a child know such a thing? I tell him sometimes I just know. He screams at me, then why tell me? Well, I said, if you are going to do such things, at least you should do them properly.
So Dr. Tannenbaum had a law for science, and well, it wasn't taken in gratitude by other scientists, because she was pretty young at the time she started doing that. And criticizing something else, someone else, wasn't really appreciated. So we can hack this health station, and I'm gonna do so, because hacking health stations are also really beneficial for a few reasons. Hacking a health station causes enemies that want to use that health station to die immediately. Well, they get poisoned, and they most likely die because of it. So let's do that. Let's put that one over here. And like that, and as a bonus we get a free health pack. Or didn't it? Oh no, we can heal at a reduced rate, so that's that. But we don't really need that right now, because we have 9 health kits to spare. So let's check out this place first. There's water here, so that might be interesting in a way. And now we have another audio diary. Yeah, a lot of this game is the audio diaries.
Some citizens have discovered ways to hack the vending machines. I should not need to remind each and every citizen of Rapture that free enterprise is the foundation upon which our society has been established. Parasites will be punished.
So he calls people that don't really condone to his set of standards parasites. And, well... in that case, we're parasites. So there we go, an ammo bandito. The ammo vending machines, of course, sell ammo. And now we have anti-personnel rounds. The way the weapons work is they have 3 different ammo types. And we have you always, in each weapon, you have normal ammo. Ammo that works better against armor opponents. And ammo that works better against squishy opponents. So let's hack the other vending machine. There we go. Let's see if we need anything in here. Maybe buy another Eve Hypo. I'm gonna do that for now. I know we're gonna come across a lot of these, but right now we should be fine. So let's find Dr. Steinman. Since he's a plastic surgeon, it's normal we will find him at Dr. Steinman's aesthetic ideals. So that's also where the marker points us to. I'm gonna hack this thing as well. So there we go. More benefits to us. I think I hear another splicer around here. And there's another audio diary at this position as well. We've been here, so let's check out the audio diary. Adam denies us any excuse for not being beautiful. Another one of, Steinman's fucked up
I am beautiful, yes.
Opinions.
Look at me. What could I do to make my features finer? With Adam and my scalpel, I have been transformed. But is there not something better? What if now it is not my skill that fails me, but my imagination?
So he's starting to lose his mind. He's thinking that because of his tools improving and he not... he thinks he's not performing at his very best because his imagination is lacking. And that, doesn't seem like the case. So we've been seeing a lot of eyes here lately as well. And that indicates we might get another plasmid soon.
I know medical pavilion is your matter. But you might want to cogitate on this. Ocean water is colder than a witch's tip. You don't heat the pipes freeze. Pipes freeze, pipes burst. Then rapture leaks. Now, I realise you're a posh sort of geezer. And frankly, I don't give a toss if you piss or go fishing. But once Rapture starts leaking, the old girl's never gonna stop. And then I'll be sure to tell Ryan he's got you a thank.
So we got an automatic hack tool, and we can use that to hack something for free. So I accidentally got another beer there. Ah, fuck, that wasn't supposed to happen because the coffee would have negated that. But hey, a little hidden supply area with an automatic hack tool. So we can't go in there yet, into the dental services area, because I've told you before, daddy dentures. We are going to come across a lot of the medicine professions. But first, let's pay Steinman a little visit. Look at that, surgery. And we hear the wail again. There we have a big daddy and a little sister. So that's something you see a lot in these dystopian societies. And that's not openable. That they start to distinguish a lot between other features as well, aside from poor and rich. Also between, beautiful and ugly. Aesthetics are a moral imperative. There we go. He feels people are obliged to make themselves pretty.
Well, we have two eyes. There's a law that says we must. Two arms, two legs, two ears, two breasts.
And,
familiar?
Yes, because you can hear Steinman over there talking about eyes and ears. Hello. And he leaves and blows up the door to his surgery wing. And then we have another fight going.
We can hear that, but they're sounding off like it's the 4th of July. Explosives are hard to come by down here. But if you get your hands on one of them telekinesis plasmids, you can catch the damn firebomb and toss it right back in its gob. Or anything else that might be standing in your way.
So that's indicating at one of my favorite plasmids in the entire series, the telekinesis plasmid. I didn't think that splice was following me, right? No, okay. She's fighting the explosive guy. So now we have... Hi, mister. Nope, you shouldn't heal. You definitely shouldn't heal. You would have died. Kill it! Kill it! Jesus Christ. Well, she was going to try and heal, but that wouldn't work as well, because we hacked pretty much everything around here. Anybody with ammo? Because I'm going to run out eventually. Apparently not, so let's do that again. So Steinman doesn't like... Okay, I forgot about that for a second. Forgot those explosions worked as well. Nope, you won't. Jesus Christ, stop firing at me. Nope. Aim, goddammit.
I'm opening you up.
What the? So that was a sound that I was almost dead, because that wasn't really great. Gracious? Graceful? Because for some reason my electrobolt never worked, and now I'm pretty much out. I'm gonna have to be careful with that. Maybe start sneaking a bit. And we passed a lot of coffee, goddammit, because that refills Eve pretty nicely. In loving memory of Winston Hofner. Because we're actually, well, at a shrine of some sort. Registry, let's, Surgeries Picasso.
When Picasso became bored of painting people, he started representing them as cubes and other abstract forms. The world called him a genius. I've spent my entire surgical career creating the same tired shapes over and over again. The upturned nose, the cleft chin, the ample bosom.
Security cameras. I can hear the infernal things all around you.
God damn it.
Brian's eyes and ears.
He blocked the audio diary. So I'm gonna do that again.
When Picasso became bored of painting people, he started representing them as cubes and other abstract forms. The world called him a genius. I've spent my entire surgical career creating the same tired shapes over and over again. The upturned nose, the cleft chin, the ample bosom. Wouldn't it be wonderful if I could do with a knife what that old Spaniard did with a brush?
So Steinman sees himself as a sort of Picasso, but then in cosmetic surgery. Let's hack the camera, which makes it, of course, work for us. There we go. So now if an enemy comes across this camera, the camera will send bots to, well, destroy that guy and not me. But as you can see, it's sometimes really annoying that... Okay, did they start shooting at me or what was that? This is also really nice. You see this corpse ready to be cremated. We can actually use the furnace, put it in there, let it burn, and that's not all. If it comes out, we get our very first Hacker's Delight, our very first tonic. With Hacker's Delight, your body converts the altered current from a hacked machine into a powerful healing agent. Hack and heal. So there we go. Physical tonics can be used to, those are kind of passive buffs. So we can only equip a certain amount, so adding to the RPG element of Bioshock itself. So let's see what's upstairs. I accidentally used another health pack, which wasn't what I wanted to do.
Disease! Your disease!
That was a headshot. There we go. Leadhead splicer. Another first aid kit, thank you. Because although I'm feeling like we come across plenty of first aid kits, but I think I should use the wrench if I can. Because, well, wrenching people is fun, clobbering people is fun. And, well, so now that we're here, this door is locked. But as you can see, there's another plasmid over there, and we can go around here. So now Andrew Ryan has stirred the hornet's nest, and he told just every splicer in the neighborhood to try and kill us. So, incineration! A very nice new plasmid.
Light up, foes. 1,000 degrees. Warning, fire spreads.
I fucking love these little videos. Those are amazing. Those are just plainly perfect. So now there's a lot of splices outside, but as you can see, there's an oil slick outside. If I light that on fire, everybody's standing in the oil spill. Well, it's lit up as well. Now we have to wait a minute, because as you can see, fire spreads.
Security, the splicers, the big daddies, the little sisters. He pumps some kind of chemical scent in the air. Pheromones, they call it. Makes them all dance to his tune.
So another nice piece of lore. Andrew Ryan fills the air with pheromones, which calls the splices to be friendly towards him and not anybody else. Because they kind of lost all free will, as we've seen it right now. Since we've allowed the camera to clean up after us, any other splices are already been dealt with, have already been dealt with. So, let's see if we can't get downstairs again, because now we can. We couldn't use these stairs before, because it's kind of blocked. But could we? We might have been able to, but then we wouldn't have that that camera at our disposal. Let's see here. I'm going to use the coffee to fill up the Eve we lost. And now with incinerate, we can actually remove certain bits of... electric buck is going to be really handy. Of scenery, because we can hear the... Well, the turret go crazy. We can remove this. And we might as well go here first. Because we're at the funeral services right now. Also, well, sort of a medical service, right? Let's check out the register. I can hear a camera, but I'm not really sure where it is. I think it's in the next room over. And there's a splicer ready to burst into flames. Ah, yeah. Goodbye. So she died of the flames. And there's something else called on fire. So right now we have, she had a bit of fun with the coffin. There's dollars, armor-piercing wrench, which we will be able to use, and a fucking turret, as you can see. So let's see, we have a turret, and it's guarding a safe. There we go, another turret for us, and we took minimal damage. Do need to be careful that I'm not in front of that camera. Now I'm gonna hack that safe. Which should be a bit harder. Hacking safe just opens them, so, oh, shit. And if any hack goes awry, we get a shock. But that was a really nasty one. That was just stupid. There we go. That should make it a bit easier. Because, saves usually start off in a really stupid position. Forces you to make a quick move. But there we go. Save becomes unlocked, and saves are always worth it. So $17, 10 bucks, and 3 armor piercing rounds. Let's take another look around, because I don't think there's another corpse here. Check out the registry. And there we have our first locked door. And let's be careful now. Wow, she was fast. Wow, okay, she was a bit faster than the other ones, also carrying a wrench. And here's the code to the door, if you didn't notice that before. So we have a music box, and there's, I can see an Eve hypo over there, but let me check it out. Eve hypo, there we go. So 0451, I don't know if it even checks if we have it. 0451, there we go. And look at that, more... stuff, automatic hack tool, a lot of shoes for some reason, and machine gun rounds, which we won't use. And another splicer has entered the building, I think. Or maybe not. Let's check out this room. There should be a camera here, I think. And there's a body floating there. So this is the storage area for the bodies. And this is a... Well, one of the cooler levels in the game. Well, there's a lot of these little set pieces, and this is one of them. And I'm not going to spoil anything, of course. So that corpse just floated from over there. And we can see somebody already having fun over there. And we're inside of water, so we need to be careful as well. And I think... yeah, okay, that's always what happens. So the light goes out, and the guy has disappeared. So if we go further, he's gone. And you can see one of the fridges has closed off. So he used the fridges to go to the other side. But we do have another tonic here. Security Expert, a new offering in the HackSmart line. Security Expert was designed for the hacker specializing in disabling electronic security measures. You won't be secure without Security Expert. Okay, so let's put that in another slot. And let's check this out, because now we're gonna have to be careful. Because we can't use Electrobolt if we're in the water. But we might, of course, be able to lure him in the water. Jesus Christ. And I can't really get out of the water. There we go. Goodbye, Doctor. Goodbye. So that guy was creepy. There was a kind of a jump scare in Bioshock, because Bioshock likes to do that. Well, this one at least. I think it's the Bioshock that has the most jump scares as well. So that body also floated over there to keep in line with the current that's floating here. I don't think there's anything inside of this coffin. No. Okay. So that was the funeral services at our first little jump scares. Let's get back into the main area. And we have a few more splices. So this is a bit of the annoying thing in Bioshock. Splices actually respawn every time you switch area. So that's why I want to do each area completely before we head into the next. Hello? Hello? We're circle strafing. Yeah, she's gonna die. Maybe you should heal. No, heal. Yes, indeed. Bye. So yeah, so that's the first casualty of our healing expertise. Because this thing will kill everybody that touches it, except us. There we go. The next area we need to go is downstairs towards dental services. And we'll do that in the next episode, because I'm going to take a little break. I am going to do this so that one can melt the ice. But I'm going to take a little break. So thank you guys enormously for watching. If you enjoyed the episode, don't forget to like it right here on the YouTube. And if you haven't already, give it a thought to subscribe to my channel, because I really appreciate any support you guys can give me. So, thank you guys again for watching, and I hope to see you in the next episode. Goodbye.